This was the scene when ISIS militants stormed the city of Marawi in the Philippines on May 23rd, triggering the longest and deadliest urban battle the Philippine military has fought in decades, and marking the appearance of a tenacious enemy with international ambitions.
The aim of taking over territory was to have the credentials to announce the establishment of a formal province of Islamic State in Southeast Asia.
Counterterrorism experts say ISIS in the Philippines is actually a coalition of local Islamist insurgent groups.
What's been so extraordinary about this coalition is that it bridges ethnic and regional ties in a way that really hasn't happened in the Philippines before.
These are the top commanders of ISIS in the Philippines. They filmed themselves planning their assault on Marawi in this video later captured and distributed by the Philippine military. Among the leaders, Abdullah and Omar Maute, two brothers from Marawi who spent time living in the Middle East. Omar Maute also taught English and preached sermons at this mosque and Islamic school in Indonesia. Somewhere along the way, he also became a violent extremist.
The terrorist threats in the Philippines is not only local in nature, it is also inherently regional because they share fighters, they share skills, they share ideas, okay, and they share human resources.
It was very easy for us.
This man is a former member of one of the Philippines' most notorious jihadi groups. In this exclusive interview with CNN, he says extremists have had decades to develop sophisticated international smuggling networks.
They can easily transport firearms and money very easily.
Between which countries?
Malaysia and the Philippines, through the southern back door.
The back door, the islands between the Philippines, Indonesia, and Malaysia, which smugglers navigate using small boats. Some of the foreign fighters battling in Marawi may have actually island-hopped their way here. Recently, the Philippines, Indonesia, and Malaysia announced plans for joint counter-terror Navy patrols and information sharing.
Allahu Akbar.
The month-long battle in Marawi, an international wake-up call to the terror threat growing in Southeast Asia. Ivan Watson, CNN, Iligan, Philippines.